Hello, welcome to this introduction to the new IDS time of flight camera, the Nion. My name is Rob Webb. I am a product sales specialist with IDS, and I'm very excited to talk to you today about this new introduction to our range of imaging products. Now, before we unveil this new product, if you are already working in the world of machine vision or 3D vision, you will likely have already heard about time of flight or TOF as a technology for acquiring 3D data. For those less familiar or new to the technology, I'd like to take a few minutes just to explain the different methods available for acquiring 3D data and give a broad indication of the pros and cons of each. So when we talk about 3D data, we are talking about acquiring depth information along with width and height. This can be achieved through some different methods. Laser triangulation or sheet of light profiling uses a projected line of light, either LED or laser, across the target, and as the object moves through the camera's field of view, or the camera moves over the object, images of the line, as it deviates over the object, are collected. By collecting these slices, it is possible to build a 3D profile. This technique can be fairly cost-effective and produces excellent 3D resolution, and it's possible to extract the surface texture or grey level information also. However, the application always requires motion of some kind, which takes time and is generally more fiddly to set up. Fringe projection triangulation is based on structured light and projects a series of patterns onto the scene, and the 3D data is computed over a series of images. This technique can also produce high accuracy, especially when using small-scale patterns. There's no motion required in order to complete a scan, and it's possible to also acquire grey-level information. However, on the flip side, this method is less tolerant to movement of the target and takes time to acquire the data. Static pattern triangulation utilizes a known pattern projected onto a scene, and the points are then mapped to the hard-coded positions of the projection to calculate the 3D data. This technique requires no movement in the scene, but can also be used on dynamic moving scenes and is often a cost-effective solution. However, the 3D resolution tends to be lower, and it's not possible to extract the grey level texture because of the projected pattern. Our Onsemi S camera works on this principle. Stereo imaging is a technique that replicates depth perception in the same way that we as humans do. Using two cameras, we look at the offset of points between the left and right cameras, and through triangulation can determine the distance to the object. Stereo imaging can be defined as passive or active. With passive stereo imaging, the system relies on texture or detail on the object or scene to determine the offset between the left and right camera. And this is fine if the object has lots of detail, but for objects with few features or texture, this produces lots of gaps in the data, as there's no information to compare. In this case, we would turn to active stereo imaging, where the camera also projects a pattern onto the scene, providing artificial texture, and this fills in gaps in data where there's no native detail. The majority of cameras in the Onsemi range that we offer use this technique. And again, it's a single shot method, meaning no motion is required. However, depending on the technique, motion is also possible. It's a robust method for generating good quality 3D data and can be used for large working volumes. Passive stereo imaging tends to be a more cost-effective solution, and with active stereo imaging, costs are in the middle to higher range, but still very affordable. In some cases, it is possible to acquire grey level data as well. Now, all of these methods use image data to determine the 3D information. A system receives a single 2D image, a pair of images, or a series of images, and then computes 3D data from this. Time of flight, as the name would suggest, uses time information to determine depth data. So, turning to the main topic of today, time of flight can be either direct or indirect. Direct time of flight is for lower cost, lower accuracy systems normally, sometimes with just a single point depth, but it's a useful technology to understand to help explain the principle. The basic time of flight principle is that we measure the time it takes an emitted pulse of light to reflect from an object back to the sensor. We take this time measurement, multiply by the speed of light, and then divide by 2, because we only care about the distance from the camera to the object. Here we see an animation of this basic principle. As the distance between the camera and the target increases, so will the time for the emitted light to reflect back, so we can determine distance by time. Indirect time of flight, the technique we are using with the IDS Nion, uses a similar technique. However, rather than sending single pulses, it sends a continuously modulating light pulse, so effectively turning it on and off very quickly at a fixed frequency. When the modulated light reflects from an object, it will shift the modulation, and it is this phase shift and some slightly more complex maths that we can use to work out the distance to the object. This simplified animation shows the process. So as the distance between the camera and the object increases, we observe that the phase shift changes. Diagrams of this technique tend to show a single point being illuminated, but we are in fact illuminating a large area so that we can build a full 3D scene. For industrial vision, indirect time of flight is the method you will most likely see used, and time of flight in general is a less complex system compared to other 3D methods. It also often has lower system costs, at least when compared to the equivalent levels of accuracy and 3D quality of other methods. So, we have seen different 3D techniques, but our new time of flight camera, the Nion, and let's bring it back in, is a new product based on a new sensor from onsemi and offers many advantages not just over the other 3D techniques, but also over other existing time of flight solutions. So let's take a look at the IDS Nion advantages. The specification table here shows the general details of this new camera. We are offering the highest resolution industrial time of flight camera on the market with the new 1.2 megapixel sensor from onsemi. This simply means more detail and more accuracy for your 3D applications. We can see the working range is between 300 millimeters and 7.5 meters. Offering support for a large range of applications and an accuracy of around 5 mm in the Z range and 2.5 mm in X and Y at a 1 meter working distance. Again, providing a good level of detail for many applications. For the light projection, we are working with 940 nanometers. This is quite deep into the near infrared range and offers the huge benefit that at 940 nanometers, water in the Earth's atmosphere absorbs much of the infrared radiation from the sun, which means even in outdoor applications or other applications that might be influenced by daylight, there will still be sufficient signal for the time of flight camera to collect data. At 850 nanometers or with visible wavelengths, the sun can easily be the dominant light source and saturate the sensor, making it impossible to capture 3D data with a ToF camera or any 3D method that relies on its own light source. 940 nanometers is also invisible to the human eye, so for any applications with human operatives, there's no disturbance from the camera. In addition to the benefits of the wavelength of light, the backside illuminated onsemi sensor is also very sensitive to this wavelength. Whereas solutions already exist with 940 nanometer illumination, the sensitivity of the existing sensors to this wavelength is low, meaning more power is required to illuminate the scene, or for texture images would require longer exposures which may cause motion blur artifacts, or require higher gain affecting the quality of the resulting texture information. Another key differentiating feature of the onsemi sensor is the in-pixel storage technology. This ensures that with the new IDS Nion, we can successfully and with high quality acquire 3D images of moving objects. Now, since time of flight acquires 3D through the time domain, any movement in the scene can have a negative effect on the 3D data. The in-pixel storage on the onsemi sensor allows for data to be collected in the sensor very quickly before processing, as demonstrated here imaging a moving conveyor with various objects including a spinning fan. With the new IDS Nion, we can achieve real-time point clouds at 30 frames per second. With other techniques, it's either not possible to achieve real-time imaging, or with single and stereo camera setups, it is possible to achieve continuous data, but at lower frame rates, or to get to 30 frames per second requires a significant reduction in resolution or the use of expensive GPU cores to process the data. With our camera, we can achieve 30 point clouds per second, making the camera viable for real-time applications. As the Nion is an industrial product, we have leaned on our experience of manufacturing industrial 2D cameras in order to provide a robust aluminium housing with IP65-67 protection rating, making it ideal for all but the most challenging of industrial environments, straight out of the box. We have not only leaned on the experience with hardware, but also with software. As the Nion is operated from our IDS Peak software, it is delivered with an easy-to-use, robust software development kit with source code examples and wide operating system support, as well as all of the features that our industrial 2D Gigi cameras offer, such as automatic reconnection, power over Ethernet, and digital inputs and outputs for synchronization with other components in the system. It is also Gigi Vision compliant, which means it is directly compatible with 3D party libraries that also support this standard. The Nion is fully integrated into IDS Peak Cockpit, with capture and display of height map and point cloud data, and the point cloud can also be stored as a PLY file for use by other 3D programs. With IDS Peak, it's also possible to perform a workspace calibration and transform the coordinate system for an off-axis angle of view of the camera. This is something that can be done programmatically or via the Peak cockpit. This workspace calibration can be used by 3D algorithms to transform from camera coordinates to real-world coordinates. Our goal with the IDS Nion time-of-flight camera is to provide a plug-and-play camera offering the best-in-class industrial performance. Now, what kind of applications might we address with the IDS Nion? Robotic guidance applications such as bin picking, production line handling, or logistics is of course a key application area. With the Gigi interface, we offer a standardized interface and long cable length, as well as support for a large range of peripheral accessories with industrial capabilities. The camera is compact and lightweight, so is ideal for mounting directly on a robot, and the integrated depth processing provides excellent accuracy. Another key application for time of flight is for guidance or collision avoidance for automated guided vehicles and autonomous mobile robots. With the precise 3D data, real-time acquisition, and 940 nanometer illumination, the Nion is ideal for these applications, as AGVs and AMRs must have fast response times to their environment and not interfere with human operatives who may be in the area. And the high quality 3D data means more accurate guidance. Agriculture is a growing area for use of 3D technology. Applications such as automated harvesting are more commonplace and require robust hardware, high quality 3D, and importantly, the ability to work outside in all levels of lighting, so day and night, and all weather conditions. As presented earlier, the 940 nanometer illumination is in a quiet spot in the sun's spectral output, so the camera can be used outdoors. The protection class of the camera means it is suited also for outdoor environments, and the real-time data supports applications requiring on-the-move processing. We might also consider body scanning applications in areas such as medical, so think about physiotherapy or patient monitoring, or in more consumer-based applications such as augmented reality for fashion or accurate measurements for tailoring or shoe fitting. Here, the key features are a large working range, precise 3D data, and a light source that is not visible and works in environments where the lighting cannot be controlled. An extension to body scanning applications is gesture recognition, and this can be used to control systems without contact, such as in gaming or virtual and augmented reality environments, in home automation, or sign language translation. Again, these applications benefit from excellent depth accuracy, infrared illumination that does not interfere with the user, and cost-sensitive hardware. For security applications, depth information is often required for access control to ensure the system is not spoofed by printed representations of a face. Here, an invisible light source is critical as it is directly illuminating a face. So the new IDS Nion is an exciting addition to our product portfolio and advances the world of industrial time-of-flight solutions. The cost-effective, high-accuracy and adaptable 3D solution can be used to address many different applications and plenty more beyond what we have presented here. We'll have a few minutes now for any questions, so please pop them in the chat and we will do our best to answer them. And if you have any projects that you would like to discuss, please contact your local sales channel. We would love to hear from you. Thank you very much for your time.